Hello everybody, welcome to today's episode, episode 26 I think, of Random Euro Truck Simulator 2. Let's first of all find out, find out which, where we're going to be allocating our bonus point to, whatever it's called, between 1 to 6. Number 1 again, okay. So now we need to do 1 to 3 because we've allocated 4, 5 and 6. So we're going to do 1 to 3 in just a second. It's number 2. Okay. So we'll do add that shortly. And now we need to find out which company we're going to be picking up from. I've had a look. There are 5 companies in Santander. So it's between 1 to 5. We're going to company number 4. Okay, let's get on with it then. Right, so let's allocate the skill points, which was to ADR and it was number 2. There we go. And then it was company number 4 in Santander. 1, 2, 3, 4, it's this one, TDC, okay. So some of these places I'm going to rule out due to taking ferries. So Soria is okay. Milan is okay. Wow, that's a big one. Birmingham, I'm not going to do. Ajaccio, I don't think I'm going to do because it involves 2 ferries. It's weird. You know, if it was 1 ferry over there, like from Marseille, you can do it in 1 ferry. I would have done it. So basically it's either going to be Milan or Soria. They're huge differences. I mean, Soria is a really close one, 352 kilometers, but Milan is 1,387 kilometers. So a huge difference in distance there. Anyway, let's set it to Milan for the time being. So it started raining after my sleep. Let's get the windscreen wipers on. Where are we actually going? Where is this place? Soon tell us. Oh, it's very close, 2 kilometers away. Okie dokie. Right, let's just double check everything. So, yeah, we're going to be doing Milan or Soria. I want to go to Milan, but I'm quite busy tonight. I could do without a really long journey. It's going to take a long time. So, kind of hoping we get Soria, even though as boring as it is. So between 1 and 2. Let's do it. Right then, 1 is, well hang on, let's just mix this up first. But once we do that, 1 is Milan, 2 is Soria. Let's see where we're going. We are going to, ooh, Milan. I'm happy to get out of Iberia. Well, it's a long one. Let's just get on with it. I don't have much time. Right, we're off to Milano. 1,387 kilometers at the moment. That could change. Shortly, we'll see. Right, there we go.
Let's go.
That's what we need. On the other side, I think. Yeah. Was it the other side? No, it's from the front. What am I doing? That was the front. Bad start.
Ready to roll.
Okay, let's have a look at the map. There's probably multiple ways to go. The longer the distance, the more variety there is in routes, I guess. Okay, looks all right up to that point. Take that squiggly road. No, that's just gonna complicate things. Well, I'm just gonna take the squiggly road. 1387. No, that makes it a lot more. What else? Right, Milan. What happens if I go this way? 1387. That makes it less. I was thinking that way. 1352. That's 13. No, it's longer. So what's that? 1387. And we said this way was 1352. It does bring the distance down at least. This looks like a more scenic route. So I guess we'll go that way. We'll do it like that. Okay.
Okay, here we go.
So let's quickly talk about Milan. I have been to Milan, officially. But I think it's only when I changed coaches, Eurolines coaches, many years ago, as a child. I didn't really see the place at all. But yeah, officially I've been there. Might have walked around for a few minutes or something, I don't know. That's about it. So this is by far the longest journey, right, that we are embarking on. We haven't done anything over 1,000 kilometers before. We haven't done anything. Oh, Jesus. We haven't done anything over 750 kilometers, let alone 1,000. Yeah. So this is something major on this series. Just got to keep cool, you know. Not, what's the word? Just relaxed. Take it easy. Enjoy the ride. We have 2 rest stops, I guess, on this journey. We won't worry about that now. So, yeah, a nice long drive through France for the most part as we transit France. a fair bit of a drive through Italy. Not much of a drive through Spain, but I think it won't be too long before we cross the border into France. Even though it is pitch black, it has gone 5 o'clock in the morning, so it should be getting lighter soon. Oh, just crashed, lovely. First sign for France on the boards there. France, Francia. To the left. So we're going to be exploring a lot of new road on this route. there's going to be a small part that I think we've already done somewhere in south of France, but it's very minimal. All of this is new road. It's really good for road exploration. Oh, this is so time consuming. I think we have to go to the last one. Yeah, the queue's not too big. At least with the ones in France, you can got more choice. There's usually two you can go to. There's never a queue. I wonder when we're going to enter France. It must be pretty close by. It's always exciting entering another country, even if it's not near as exciting when it's a country that you've been to many times on the game. I get that, but even so, it's quite nice just changing countries on the game. Oh, we are coming up to it. very shortly. You can see it on the map there. Now that we're in France, we have more options at these toll booths. We'd have to go right to the far right hand side. It's more convenient. Right, so we had been heading north, and now we're going to be heading west towards Italy, with Spain to the south of us, almost kind of driving along the Spanish border in a way. I think there'll definitely be some turnoffs for Spain on the right hand side to the right. But yeah, I'm happy to be out of Spain, I'm happy to be back into France, and I'll be even happier when I'm in Italy. I'm not happy to be experiencing all these bloody paid toll things all the time. Right nuisance. Right, turn off coming up for LAC. So obviously that's a place we have been to a long, long time ago. Interesting place, LAC. That chemical facility, whatever it was. So yeah, we're now joining up with the road we have already driven on. But I know that we're going to continue heading along this road. And we would have, all that time ago, we would have come from the north. So there'll be a turn off soon. Soonish. And you'll see that yellow line heading north. We continue west. Sorry, not west, east. We're heading east. get this. Why is there another pay thing coming up straight away? You just had one. It's quite inconsistent. You can sometimes drive quite a long way without seeing any, and then suddenly two will crop up in a short distance of each other. You can see as well on the map that this looks like this is where we're going to split off from the road we've already, the route we've already taken, as I mentioned earlier. That's going to be heading north, but we are heading east. Oh no, looks like it's not here. That's just the road going in a different direction. Right. Oh no, let's see. Maybe it is here. I think it is. Where should I be? I'm getting confused. We don't want Bordeaux. Yeah. Oh, we have to go this way. Okay. So yeah, it's not here. This is just how the road goes. Okay. What a dick. He wouldn't let me get past him. Anyway, this is where we split up. We came from the other way. Before, he wouldn't let me get past him. He was going slow, and suddenly we're trying to get past him, and he sped up, the bastard. Let me try and get him again. He won't get past him this time. Look how slow he's going. Oh, we're going to a pay point anyway. Surprise. We get past this prick anyway. Road rage. It's not even real, it's just AI. Imagine what I'm really like on the roads. I'm alright on the roads. a photo point there. Should I pull over and see what that's all about? That's weird. Quite a long way. What is that? So we can get a photo. Landmark tour. It must be that, but it's not giving me that yellow thing telling me what it is. It's a bit weird. We had that at Frankfurt Airport as well. Let's just take the picture anyway. It must be that castle, chateau. Well, I can't get any closer to it. Right, I'm off. Let me in, let me out. Come on. Come on, let me go. We could have pulled out there. Thank you very much. Chuck a block. Yeah, go on, go on, go on. You can go. But you can't. Hang on, you can't. You're going to crash. Jeez. The guy behind me almost crashed into me. What a cheeky bugger. So this is also previously explored road. I'm going to stop for a sleep next time I come to one. Well, it probably won't be very long. It's when we come to one of these toll road booths. There always seems to be somewhere to sleep there. Unless we see a turn off for somewhere to sleep as well, a service station. Whoever comes first. I think what I found disappointed about Spain is that I don't think that they have any trains there. Like in France, I think there are trains that run, not too many. Occasionally you see some track and some trains, I think. It's like I'm going to have another sleep as well. Did think I would need to. Let's see. So I think this already explored route was when I drove in the other direction from Lyon to Perpignan, and I had that terrible experience in Perpignan. So that was wrong, didn't need to do that. be too far from Italy because we've still got a fair bit of a drive in Italy. It's a good few hundred kilometres. But I don't think it's coming up just yet. I think we've still got some time in France yet. I know we're going off this kind of route as well. We're going on, I think, onto a smaller, more scenic road as well at some point. So looking forward to that.
Straight on. At the roundabout, take the third exit.
So I had to go for another sleep. Didn't need to, but it just takes the pressure off, and I like driving in the daytime, ultimately. Much nicer. We've got 14 hours left, and we're due to arrive in 7 hours, so no problem there with time.
exit now. The roundabout, take the first exit. Exit now.
Well, isn't this a nice route? This was what I manually chose. I know you can do it on the GPS. You can choose like quickest route or small roads or shortest distance. I've got mine set to I've got mine set to fastest route. So we just change it to shortest distance. That's what I prefer. Anyway, we've got some kind of video thing coming up. Let's check this place out.
The roundabout, take the first exit.
Great, so I've damaged my truck just to get into this viewpoint place. Great. Right, I hope it's worth it. Yeah, it is. Lake Serponchon. Lovely and scenic, isn't it? Gives me a chance to drink some water. Well deserved rest for me, this. On this mammoth journey. Santander in Spain. Milan in Italy. I'm enjoying every single moment of this drive. No mistake about that. Ooh, so we're going to be driving through this little funny tunnel shortly. This is what it's all about, ladies and gentlemen. Grusse.
Thank you.
like coming to the border of Italy. Saw our meeting, almost crashed head on there. It wasn't a good start to life in Italy, was it? This is definitely cheaper than the last place I got petrol in, which I think was Portugal. I'm sure it was €2 per litre there. It was exactly 2 litres, I remember. Yeah, I really like this road because it's a nice long road through, well, initially through France and now through Italy in an Italian village. Let's see how Italian this village is. I can't see any shops or signs or anything. is a bit of a, what I would like to see in the future of Euro Truck Simulator 2, they just kind of added more roads so that you could potentially always avoid the motorway. In most cases, you know, if you're driving from, I don't know, northern France down to Italy, if you could kind of know, drive on like secondary roads, that'd be really cool. Interesting, this place doesn't have a rest area. In France, all of the toll booths, toll stations, they always have rest areas as well. Right, so we're not far away now. We now drive on this Italian motorway. Milano, that's us, isn't it? But it's only to go straight on towards Bern in Switzerland. Not to go to Milano. We are going to Milano. Okay. Whatever you say, sir. Oh no, the motorways are only 80 kilometers per hour in Italy, it seems.
Keep left, and then turn left. Turn left.
It's weird, we're going through Torino. Normally, you avoid the cities by, you know, by going along the motorway. Interesting.
Turn left. Go straight on. straight on.
Like this place is not in the city, middle of nowhere by the looks of it. There's nowhere to sleep there either, which is a problem.
At the roundabout, take the second exit.
Okay, it's not in the middle of nowhere, it's not like in the country, it's just in some small place near Milan.
At the roundabout,
the problem is there's nowhere to park or to sleep, so we're going to have to go for quite a long drive probably to find somewhere to sleep. Let's have a look.
Exit now.
I don't even think it says I'm in Milan yet.
Turn left.
I think when I enter it will say Milan discovered. Let's see. Milano. Italiano. Italia.
Finally, we are here.
I didn't say we're in Milan. Jeez, this was a long journey. It takes quite a lot out, quite a lot out of me, you know, a journey like this. There's going to be much longer ones ahead as well. Not for the moment, because we're restricted to 1.5 kilometers, so 1,500 kilometers maximum. No, I need a bit more on that. Those boxes are in the way though. I'm a bit of a tricky one this. Don't get too much on it. That looks alright actually. That was very good. It looks bloody perfect. Well, I never. I've messed up easier ones than this, I'll tell you that. There we go. Ooh, we got another bonus point thing, skill point, whatever it's called. We'll sort that out there for next time. Right, we've got to now find somewhere. How much? 3.78% we've done here. We've got to find somewhere to sleep. We are here. It looks like I'm going to have to go there. Let's see if it's anywhere closer. There's a place there actually. I think we'll go there.
Time to get the job done.
See, it looks like with Milan, they've just plonked all these companies sort of all over the place, like quite a long distance from each other. So it'd be interesting to see where we end up next. So we've got more flexibility now that we're out of Iberia. You know, we could be heading to numerous countries, all sorts. I want to be heading east, preferably. I don't mind checking out Italy, so I wouldn't mind sort of heading south, exploring a bit of Italy, potentially. I definitely don't want to head back to France, back in the westerly direction. I don't particularly want to go to Germany either. I just want to kind of get east. Basically, I suppose I want to go through Slovenia and beyond. Right, almost there.
Keep right.
Is the airport? I think maybe not. Is it the airport? I don't know. Finally. That's the end of the episode. Thank you for watching.